This brought back flashbacks. A motorcycle crash was like one of the first videos of a death I've ever seen.
I don't want to watch people die, dude.
No, I saw this accidentally as a kid. Like,
is this what sparked your interest in death comps?
Maybe, possibly. Maybe dark. Maybe both of them dark.
So my penis is really small.
It's not right. I mean, my Nazis did meth. They weren't right either.
And this motherfucker rolled it around in a suitcase.
What meth Nazis do you know about, dude?
This is unusable, guys. I have to cut all of this.
I don't mean to brag, but I am pretty good at Minesweeper.
You guys never heard how his death led to anime titties?
Sodomy is not illegal if it's a ghost.
I'm on the wrong side of the fence here, apparently.
He literally said it. He thought that that would be a good idea.
To come out and look sickly. Like in a wheelchair.
Oh, yeah, I did see that. Yeah. You wanted to do the Willy Wonka thing, right?
Yeah, yes. That's exactly what he wanted to do.
Except he can't do a front flip or a cartwheel, so instead he wanted to rip his shirt off.
Like Hulk Hogan.
Chapo Straphouse said it best. Like, seriously, fuck whatever stupid Republican dickwad convinced him not to do it, because that would have been hilarious.
He'll be saved in the Library of Congress or whatever forever.
But unfortunately, there would have been people who were literally convinced by that, like, holy shit, he's so strong! He is Superman.
Oh my god. It would have been so many people's phone backgrounds.
But come on, dude, for the laugh, that's hilarious.
Well, he was feeling great about himself. Yeah, because he's obviously on the craziest fucking drugs.
Steroids.
That the world has. He's feeling great.
They put him on HGH.
So yeah, I don't know if you guys have seen that. I'll play a quick clip of Trump's excitement.
One thing with me, the nice part.
The dude with the mask.
I went through it. Now they say I'm immune. I feel so powerful. I'll walk into that audience. I'll walk in there, I'll kiss everyone in that audience. I'll kiss the guys and the beautiful women and everybody. I'll just give you a big fat kiss.
So he's feeling really good, right?
Wouldn't allow it, though.
He says, I feel like going out and kissing everybody. I'll kiss the guys.
Kiss
the
guys.
And the beautiful women.
The ugly women, though.
Did you hear is this the same part where he was talking about how like cops and vets want to come up to him, you know, but he can't do it because he has COVID or something, but he would totally kiss him.
I would totally
but
kiss
I would
you
kiss them all. Yeah, no, this kissing thing, I thought this was one slip up, but there's another video of him doing the same thing.
He talks about kissing. Yeah, he talks
I'm
about
immune,
kissing.
They tell me I'm
playing another
come
one.
Down and start kissing everybody.
Yeah, it's like
I'll kiss every guy.
It's bizarre, but
woman,
I think this was all when he was
look
mad.
At that guy.
So,
how handsome he is.
Who knows?
I'll kiss him.
Man,
how handsome
politics
he is.
Is
not
weird.
With a lot of enjoyment, but that's okay.
Not with a lot of
he sounds like he's... Okay. Does he sound like he's drunk to anybody else? Like, it's with a lot of enjoyment.
It's all the drugs that he's on. He's literally so fucking high.
He's so yeah. fucking high right now. It's crazy.
And then he even did like a
he did a dance too, right?
Well, I was gonna say he did like a PSA almost to like elderly people talking about how
oh my god that was hilarious.
He can get them drunk. Don't tell the other guys, but I'm a senior too. Like nobody had a fucking clue that he was old or something.
Yeah, 74 is old. What?
He literally does not see himself for what he is. He sees himself as like the superhero, like the Superman that I was talking about.
He has so much main character, just energy in his brain right now.
Yeah, like he's not 74 years old and fat and out of shape and stands awkward.
He thinks that all those people are his harem.
I mean, they are. Look at them.
That's why I get to kiss them all.
Look at that dude in the background saluting.
There's a guy. Like,
yo, Bung, pull up a... His like Kim Jong Un style coming off the helicopter after after coming back from COVID. That's the best one.
He's with Kim Jong Un?
No, he's not with Kim Jong Un.
Oh,
it's like
okay.
No.
Like, why is Kim Jong Un there?
It's like a produced video, dude. It's like cringy.
Oh, it's like propaganda. Okay.
Yeah, it's like a dude.
It's probably on his web. His.
Oh, it's White for House sure on Twitter.
Everybody just wants to kiss me. I want to kiss them too.
They all love kissing me.
Yo, look at the angle he's standing at. He's like, looks like he's gonna tip over.
He looks like Smooth Criminal.
It really
does. Yeah, dude, he's fucking nuts, dude. He's literally a fucking walking joke.
Crap, I bet. But he's probably going to go, too, because the Lakers won the playoffs. He's probably going to go, that guy, LeBron James, does not deserve to come to the White House. Even if I didn't have COVID, he's still not invited, because fuck him.
Are you?
They wouldn't go. And why do I hear an echo?
Yeah, well, there's an echo.
Because he's
right
standing right next to me.
Oh, and my God. You guys can't do that. I'm sorry.
I can't control it. He spilled another mop bucket of water, and he's...
You spilled the first
one. I didn't spill the first one. You did, clearly, because you're the one that kicked over a mop bucket.
You kicked
I don't know how you could kick over.
I'm hearing four people argue right now.
This is unusable, guys. I have to cut all of this. I can't hear. I can't understand you.
Well, I can't help it that he kicks over mop buckets and blames me for it.
Why is that? Why are you next to each other then?
Because he's cleaning up the... I'm in my bedroom, but he roundhouse kicked a bucket of water and it was spilled from the bathroom through the hallway into my bedroom.
Are you kicking mop buckets like that?
And for some reason, he keeps blaming me for the first time. I don't know how I would have.
Why is there always mop buckets all over the place?
Earl's a mop enthusiast.
Bro, first off, Eric left that first mop bucket there. I did not. I claim the second one, but you did the first one.
It was there all day at work. Like, I left for work, mop bucket was up in correct position. Came home from work, and there was mop bucket water everywhere. So it wasn't me. It could have been the cats, it could have been Terrell, but it was not me. And Terrell's convinced I did it for some reason. I don't understand how. Because I leave before him for work. So clearly, if it was still up by time he left for work, how would I have done it?
I didn't kick the bucket. Someone kicked the bucket. I thought I did it.
We all left before the mop bucket was spilled. So there is no possible way. I will concede that maybe it was the cats. It's totally possible.
I mean, did T ever at one point say you kicked over the mop bucket?
Yes.
Because he accused me of doing it, and I know I didn't.
And I let it go because fuck it.
They're playing Among Us, but with a mop bucket.
Terrell is sus.
He was last seen with the mop bucket.
And Terrell also barfed on my porch before he lived here, and he still won't admit to it.
That's true.
I thought that was confirmed.
Well, I wasn't me. There's puke by Terrell's car.
On your side.
That
makes zero sense when it was in the... Do you see how he blames for just... He has no stance for anything.
It was underneath the passenger side.
It wasn't because it was in the road by the driver's side door. I was in the passenger side, correct? So why would I walk around the car to barf on the ground? I'm talking about the porch anyway.
All right, all I'm saying is that I got out the car first and you got out behind me.
And he crawled over to the other side.
Yeah, I decided to set T up fully because I knew he was going to puke on the porch later. So I puked on the opposite side of the car, hammer drunk, just because I knew he was going to puke on the porch at a later moment. You got me.
That's a 9,000 IQ player there.
Were you drinking and driving, T?
No, he had a sip of a beer, did not drink anymore.
I guess. All right. Well, I guess case closed.
Let's get back to that video.
Okay. I'm glad we all worked it out and everyone's happy now.
Nothing's been worked out.
Nah, it sounds like it's all good. Sounds like it's all water under the bridge. All vomit under the car.
See, that's the whole thing. Like, I don't care about any of this. Terrell's just upset about it. I don't care. The mop bucket was spilled. Whatever.
Sounds to me like T's got a bad case of the Trumps. Can't admit he was wrong.
Oh, dude, you guys missed it. The joke's on me. Terrell just ripped open his shirt and it's Superman on me.
How much did Donald Trump spend to get this video made?
That's what I'm saying, dude. Let's bring this up. Start it over. All right, let's see this. The music goes well with it.
I don't know if I can play the music, but I mean, I'll play it for you guys and I'll just mute it.
So epic. Look at how it touches down.
It's like God himself has reached down from the heavens and has returned triumphant.
He walks so weird.
He also didn't salute that Marine when it was coming off.
This is also the least weird parts of his walk that they put in the video. Like, they cut out all the weird shit that they could.
They also cut out the gasping.
Yeah.
You notice how they have it always at an angle where you can't tell how far leaning forward he is.
Yo, do you think he has, like, those shoes that Michael Jackson wore in Thriller?
He puts nails on the floor and then slots the shoes onto him.
He's a smooth criminal. He's not a smooth criminal, but I guess.
The joke was already made.
That's my favorite Trumpism, though, is that, like, close fist, like, fist pump, you know? It's not really, like, in the air. It's like his thing, dude.
I like the little low wave. Like, he never lifts up his hand all the way up.
Yo, do you guys see the video of his rally, I think, last night or the night before, of him dancing? The best comment I ever saw was, it looked like SpongeBob when he got in the band. Oh, there we go, dude. There's the fist pump, but slow-mo. Is he wearing a coat, or is that his actual suit jacket, dude? It's so big.
Wait, you've never realized how big his suits are?
Holy shit, I've actually never looked at this.
But, dude, like that?
Whoa, that.
He has, like, the Joker's overcoat.
Dumb.
That has to be an overcoat.
It is an overcoat, okay.
I think. Actually, I don't know.
But is it, like, a hybrid overcoat suit jacket?
I know what you guys are talking about. Those are like those Wall Street overcoats you see.
Yeah, he's not wearing a suit jacket. He's wearing this suit. This,
look at how big it is. It's like a dress.
It's like what two kids wear when they want to sneak into the movies and they stack on each other.
His arms are so skinny and his body so large.
He wore that, I think, too, like in his Home Alone 2 cameo appearance.
Yes.
Nah, dude, it's the Wall Street Duster.
Still ugly.
I mean, I don't like the material it's made out of, but I like the length. And if it was made out of a different
whatever
material,
he's wearing is not suit material, not though. It's literally all elastic and like straps trying to hold them together.
Why is there so much video of Trump dancing right now? Is he like?
Because he's high. He needs to cool down. He needs a glass of water. But the problem is he doesn't know how to drink water.
Yeah, you notice when he's clapping, he only moves one hand. He claps with one hand.
He does, yeah. He can only use one side of his body at a time.
Yeah, like he can't expend the energy. Why do you think he uses two hands to drink?
I don't know, dude. My dad's not even 70 yet, and Trump moves better than my dad.
He is a man of God, as evidenced by when he was elected, he was sworn in under the Holy Bible.
Oh, yeah, because people don't lie in front of the Bible.
Well, luckily for myself, I'm also a reverend, so I can start my own religion.
I forgot about that. Yeah, when are you starting your own religion?
You're a reverend of your church. You could just make our own church and become a reverend of your own church.
That is true.
We could claim that the podcast is a religious service, and then we write this off on our taxes. We never have to pay taxes. We could buy whatever we want and say that we require. Because this is a weekly meeting. What you say is required, but I think that's one of the main tenets of being a religion is that you have to have like a weekly service or something. You say that this is it, and that what we just worship toxicity.
So would like our idol we pray to just be a statue of Adam, or
yeah.
May the stocks forever be in your favor,
and all of our like tenets come from Jimmyisms.
One pork chop is a snack. Two pork chops is a meal. As was said, was done.
And so they were eaten.
Dominic's has the best pizza.
It does have the best pizza.
And wings.
But have you ever...
Did Domino's have the best pizza?
No, Dominic's.
Dominic's.
So, Jimmy went to a local Italian restaurant, said... This is some really good Italian food. We asked him what he ordered, and he said pizza.
and he had some of his cousin's wings.
So pizza and wings was an Italian delicacy.
I thought he just got wings. I didn't know he got pizza.
Either way, neither is Italian. Is the Italian? He got an American ass pizza and wings.
Pizza. I don't know about pizza.
It's not Italian.
Italian meal known as wings with the good common Italian sauce of buffalo.
Do they make Italian style wings? Or they just put like Italian dressing on it or whatever?
It's just chicken wings with Italian seasoning.
Italian wings has got to be like the garlic
parmesan all over it.
Is that good?
No, they're good after one. They're only good for one. After that, you're like, dude, this is...
Wings should not be this.
Yeah, you're like, this is kind of too much.
It's usually a dry rub anyway.
No, they'll be saucy, dude. It's butter, garlic, and parmesan.
Yeah, this does not, I'm imagining this does not sit well.
It doesn't.
Just thinking of these flavors.
I got them one time at Buffalo Wild Wings, but I got them at like, yeah, like 18 wings, and I got them as like a sixer.
Okay, yeah, that's good. He didn't get them all.
And dude, I had like two of them, and I was like, you know, these are like decent, but I'm not going to finish these because they're just too much.
Now, did you get wings or did you get boneless wings? I must ask.
Oh, I think that was still my wing days. Now I go boneless.
So you get chicken nuggets is what you're saying.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. I get like baby chicken tenders.
Baby tenders.
Baby chicken nuggets, and you want to call them wings.
There's a video of this guy going to like his town hall and trying to get the town to abolish the like saying chicken or boneless wings and saying it's like an abomination.
I saw that, dude, and they like upheld it too. I think they're like,
yeah, you gotta look up this video.
It's crazy.
And he was, but the thing is, he was trolling his dad because his dad's like on the city council or whatever. Or...
Oh yeah, the guy in the long hair and the glasses. Yep, in that town hall.
Oh, this guy.
Yeah, that guy.
He looks like a real hero.
Just, yeah, you need to watch.
So what, he hates boneless wings? Like, what's his bag?
I'm totally on his side.
He made a fair point.
Fresco, question for you. What are the best wings you ever had?
I don't know. I can't think of any that... yes, I can.
I was hoping you weren't going to let me down.
A local place.
I know.
You know. This is serious shit, guys. Boneless chicken wings need to stop.
They're not fucking chicken wings. There's no such thing as boneless chicken wings. You're just fucking chicken nuggets.
Exactly. Thank you, brother. Yes. Together we must rise.
To be fair, there's nothing wrong. There's nothing wrong with chicken nuggets with sauce on them.
And call them chicken nuggets.
Can you prove that they're not from the meat of the wing?
What's even more annoying, even than that, is fucking cauliflower wings. Cauliflower wings, there's no such thing as fucking cauliflower wings. Cauliflower don't have wings.
They don't have wings. This is true. Not unless you pour a Red Bull on them while they're growing.
You got to be careful. They might become sentient.
Aren't plants technically sentient?
I don't think so. No. I don't think plants have thoughts. Did you guys ever read that book in where a kid becomes a plant? By like, I forget what he did, but he would just like sit in dirt and water himself and sit in the sun and... meditate on becoming a plant, and eventually he started to really become one.
Yeah, where did Eric go?
He said he messaged me and said that T is still too close to his room, so he can't get in Discord because otherwise you're going to hear the echo. T, why are you still standing outside Eric's room?
Because I'm fucking cleaning.
What are you cleaning? You've been cleaning forever.
Drying what? Still, you spilled a whole mop bucket. You got to go find all the places and dry up the water.
How much water do you dump?
An entire full mop bucket. So more or less, you really gotta just like kind of just make sure you get all the excess water.
Thank you for the breakdown, P. I just don't think it would have taken me 20 minutes to mop up water.
That's what I'm saying. Like, you just get most of it. It'll fucking evaporate.
I had to get towels and dry it off too.
I mean, get most of it. The rest of it's gonna fucking.
Dude, that's still, I feel like, not a 20 minute.
I think it's a 5 minute job. I think that.
Did you go under a bed and go do it too?
Still be 5 minutes.
I guess, man. I don't know what's under the bed. Is the bed messy? Is the bed also full of other stuff?
His fucking mothership is under the bed.
Well, let Eric just get into his room.
No, Eric's in his room, but because T's talking outside of his room.
He has his thing turned off.
No, Eric's in the kitchen.
Well, tell him he can go to his room.
I want to hear T tell Eric to go to his room.
T, tell Eric to go to his room right now.
Tell him.
First, I will tell you this. Fuck off. Eric, you can go in your room now.
That's not how we wanted you to say it.
Well, I don't do commands.
T, don't tell Eric to go to his room.
Hey, Zach, fuck off.
Hey, why don't you get some new content?
I'll post that porno I have of your mom.
Oh, God.
Go ahead, make me famous.
Actually, this is a great segue. Speaking of weird porn that nobody wants, Netflix.
Don't tell me what. Oh, okay, never mind. I was about to say.
Be careful. Be careful.
You want to finish that sentence?
Netflix has a new movie.
As soon as you said Netflix,
it's called Cuties, and it's about very young little girls dancing. And some people might really want that if they want to speak up now.
No, that's
very silent.
What French movie you're talking about.
He's watched it.
Yeah, it's actually called something else, but it translates to Cuties.
Yeah, and Netflix did change the poster too.
The poster was not the issue.
the whole movie was it.
But yeah, it's about the sexual exploitation of young girls, and in the process of making a movie about sexual exploitation of young girls, they are sexually exploiting young girls.
Basically, exactly what it is it's about it, but they do it. They instead of just talking about it in the movie, they show.
It's like doing a dog fighting documentary on Michael Vick. And then actually show.
But you have the dogs actually fight for the fight scenes.
But I guess recently the Netflix chief executive has spoken out and said he's surprised that America is having the discussion about censoring storytelling. He's like insulted about how people are responding to
them. I think the movie's real popular in France, though.
Well, we're not French.
That doesn't make it good. A lot of things are popular in France. And I don't think we want any of that shit.
Yeah, only things that are America are good in America are good. If it's popular in anywhere else, it's not good, like soccer.
That's true. Okay, so Zach is now on the side of Cuties, it sounds like.
No, I'm saying that Cuties is bad because it's not liked in America. Only things in America are good.
It's not liked in parts of America. I'm sure other parts of America are really loving it. Just more. There's a silent group of people who are probably really enjoying Cuties.
Silent majority.
Yeah, the silent majority.
Hey, do you guys know what Cuties is about?
Yeah.
It's a tale of a woman, a young woman embracing her sexuality and showing it off to a bunch of old men.
So, like, I was talking about this with my girlfriend. She watched the whole movie. Apparently, it's about, like, a Muslim girl who's, like, not... has something wrong with her family or whatever, and like goes to this new school and like tries to fit in. She like tries to fit in with the like cool kids who just like talk about blowing dudes and stuff at like 12 years old. But then they like actually like show, I don't know if they show it, but like I think they like very like overtly hint to like these 12 year old girls like blowing dudes.
I thought it was about twerking.
That it definitely is about that.
I haven't watched the movie, but I saw a review which showed clips, and I had to like look away because it's so uncomfortable. There's definitely children twerking and like doing bedroom eyes and like.
Yeah, but that's not what it's about.
Okay, but it's what's in it.
I mean, I get what you're saying. So I get what you're saying that it has uncomfortable moments in it, but it's not about. It's not like people just twerking. You know what I'm saying? It's not. It's not the point of the movie.
Well, yeah, I know. I think we all get that.
I don't know. It seems like we're.
But it seems like I would say that none of that is required to be in the movie for it to be about that. You don't need to show things.
Well, then how would you know?
You can make a movie about a serial killer and say that he kills people. You don't have to show the murder.
But wouldn't it be more watchable if they were?
No.
No. Depends on what audience you want to see it.
I guess my point is if they're exploiting children, then yeah. I don't think that's right. So they are.
Well, I think we could make the case that they are. From the scenes that I saw, it was...
Well, I think that's the argument behind it. Some people are arguing they are, and some people are arguing that it's true. So, you know, they're showing the real deal. But at the same time, it's like, how much do you show to get your point across, and how much is too much? That's the argument.
I think it's in poor taste. I don't know that they're exploiting the kids, but it's definitely in poor taste.
Well, I don't see. Here's my issue with the whole argument is I haven't seen it to really know how much there even is in it. Because, like, the definition of what's too much is going to differ from someone to someone. Some, you know, middle America Christian family in Kansas is going to think that even showing the girls, like, with makeup on is too much. And other people are going to be like, you know, maybe absent parents are going to be like, I don't give a fuck. I'll put my kid on the TV as long as it's making me money. Like, what's too much? I don't know.
Yeah, but let's put it this way. In my opinion, I watched the same review that Bunk did, and I actually watched all of those scenes that he showed, and even those number of scenes that were showed spread over 2 hours.
It's 2 hours long?
Is probably... No, I'm just saying if it's a two-hour movie.
Oh, damn.
I'm giving it the benefit of the doubt. I'm giving it the benefit of the doubt, 2 hours. It's too many scenes of explicit movements. The rest of the movie might be compelling enough to make up for it, but the scenes are pretty explicit.
They're shot like a Nicki Minaj music video.
Yeah, like a music video.
Like the WAP video?
Yes. Yeah, it's shot exactly like that.
Like zoom-ins on crotches and butts.
This trailer is actually not showing they're showing it looks more
tame than it actually is.
Way more tame, yeah. Because they're cutting quick and not showing the extended cuts where it zooms in on
their crotches.
Like on baby pussy. And yeah, it's really weird.
That's fucked.
I can try to bring up scenes, but I'll definitely not show that in the video. It'll be blurred as fuck.
I wouldn't even bring it up, to be honest.
I don't really want it. I'm not going to keep searching for it because I don't want it.
You're going to get flagged by the fucking FBI, dude.
I know. So, yeah, you guys can just look it up on your own.
I don't want to get flagged by the FBI.
You're not going to get flagged but from the
FBI. It is a movie.
It's a fucking movie. And there's no nudity or anything. It's just...
They technically didn't do anything wrong, but it's just morally and it just feels... Like, legally, I guess there's nothing wrong being
it's
done
It's just
here.
Some OJ shit getting off on technicalities.
I didn't say technicalities because it's not like...
When I first heard of this movie, I only heard about the controversy of everyone hating it. And I was like, these people need to lighten up. Like, it's a movie about... this, and it's probably saying that it's wrong, right? And then it looked in the movie and it is not. It's saying it like it's about her embracing that.
I didn't get that.
From what I understand, it's to show her triumph of accepting that part and becoming a cool girl.
Okay, so I'm gonna spoil a scene in it that does not give me that vibe. Well, unless you're gonna watch, if anybody's gonna watch it, I won't spoil it.
Couldn't say that I care about watching it, so go ahead. Yeah, the okay for me.
So there's a scene in this where, if I remember correctly, so the girl gets followed by like this creep, essentially, and like he's getting more and more attracted to her because of the way she acts. You know, he essentially steals this guy's phone.
Oh my god, sorry.
Yeah, Eric's not watching. I think you're talking about the exact scene that we're watching, too. A dude just came onto her, and now she's hiding, and now she has a phone.
That is the scene.
She also just pulled her pants and underwear off.
Oh, my God.
Yes, exactly. So I don't think this is about embracing that as a young child. I think it's the point to show that... I think it's the point to show that this is the world you live in now, that this is going to happen. Girls are going to dress this way. Girls are going to act this way because that's what society dictates if you want to fit in. And then unfortunately, a negative consequence of that is that grown-ass adults are going to be looking at these girls. You know what I mean? It's unfortunate. I don't think they should exploit it, the children, in these ways. But I think ultimately it's making a good point.
I think I can agree with you that as far as maybe that's the goal of the movie, is to show truth, I guess, to show the world of what it is. But it just seems like it has become a part of the thing that it is trying to say is wrong by doing it.
I agree. I'm with you on that page. But I think people are just hearing that it has these things in the movie and not realizing the big picture about what the movie's trying to enlighten you on.
I think that's definitely happening too. And that's why when I first heard about the movie, I was like, you know what? I'm going to go watch this movie because if everyone's hating it, they're just hating it for no reason. But then, yeah, I don't know. After seeing a review and it showing some of the scenes, I was like, I don't think I can watch this. I will be so uncomfortable the whole time. It's not worth it.
Yeah, no, I don't want to say it on the fence because it's not like I would watch the movie because of all the shit that goes on in it. But at the same time, I'm not going to denounce the message if that is the message.
I mean, like, when we were watching that review, there were scenes that they showed at the end where I was like, you know, that's really not that bad. Like, they showed the kids, like, finding a used condom or something. Like, that's not that bad. And then, like, them talking about the blowjobs, like blowing their older brother or something.
It was, like, a super bad kind of...
Yeah, like, I was like, I talked about stupid shit when we were kids, like... Like, every kid is going to talk about sex and stuff like that, or subjects like sex.
Talking bottles of piss and...
Yeah, and I mean, like...
Do you remember when we did that?
The living puddle of piss? Yes.
Yeah.
What?
We made a comic that was like an anthropomorphic puddle of piss.
It came to life.
Yeah.
Yo, Fresco and I just rode the pine, like, for 4 straight years in TCYO basketball. And we had literally used the coach's, like, whiteboard that was supposed to be used for drawing up plays, and we would just draw out, like, our comic.
Luke, you know what came up in a conversation with Nick and I last night?
What's that?
You remember Kumquisha?
Yeah, dude. I don't.
That fucking doll, dude.
Yo, I had the teachers rolling with that. I walk in the class and my teachers are like, "Yo, what the fuck is that?" I was like, "Kumquisha, I won it for free from that." I don't even know, like.
It was like you got like tickets from like being good in class or something.
Yeah.
Oh, yo, Nick, for some reason, talking about Kumquisha again just reminded me the name. Remember the female ridiculous name we came up with? That's a Dark Souls character. Her name is Jaleesa Farkins.
Yes, Jaleesa Farkins. But to get back to the...
I think we can get away.
No, I don't think that that's a bad thing to talk about because it is reality. Kids are going to talk about those things. And I don't think it's bad that they talk about it either because most of the time it's from a completely uneducated perspective anyway. Like, it's kids talking about things that they think.
How can you make that claim that they don't know?
Well, I'm saying most kids don't actually know about sex and they just come up with things. They just say things as though they know.
So how do you know that, though?
I mean, I don't.
But maybe they do. And maybe that's the problem. The
information is always becoming more and more available every generation. Whereas we just could go off what was on TV and just, like, sex jokes on Friends or whatever.
I mean, I had seen porn real young. I had seen porn.
I'm sure, yeah.
Saying we were young enough that the internet wasn't a huge thing until like right around puberty, I would say, right before puberty.
What I'm saying is, even having seen porn at a young age, you still don't understand everything involved with it. You know what I mean?
Yeah, no, I don't think they understand everything. So just to, I guess, like an example, I took my kids to the park. My daughter's almost 5, and my son's 1.5. Just for perspective. But anyway, so she was trying to make, my daughter was trying to make a friend. The girl ended up being a total snot. So she didn't want to hang out with my daughter. Anyway. So the girl, I was listening to what the girl was talking about with her other friend and these boys. Now, keep in mind, this girl couldn't have been older than, 7, 8 years old, around that ballpark. But she was wearing like a crop top t-shirt, which I just, you know, I wouldn't normally think anything of it. She's just a kid. But it was skin tight. So she's got a crop top on.
Just like Cuties.
Yeah, just like Cuties. And she's wearing these extremely short shorts where, like, this girl's butt cheeks were hanging out of. Now, I'm not going to assume that the girl decided to choose that. Maybe the parent doesn't see an issue with it. Whatever. But then the girl was talking with her friend and then said something to the boy along the extent of... something like you know, I've touched a penis, and you think about it, and you go, you think about it, yeah, like you think about it from Fresco's perspective, like she obviously doesn't get what she's saying, but then at the same time, it's clearly obvious that a 7 or 8 year old knows that men have penises.
But she knows something about it.
Like I mean, from experience. I didn't know that a foreskin was a fucking thing till sex ed, and I realized I didn't have one.
Dude, I didn't know that either. That was the same. I was like, what is that?
Dude, I'm pretty sure we didn't even really know boners.
When people talked about circumcised, I was like, I don't even know what is that?
Yeah. I should probably keep all that in mind that the kids probably have no clue to the extent of what they're talking about. But just having kids, it just I don't want to believe the world is all bad because I don't think... I like to believe that most people are genuinely decent people, but it is scary to have that thought.
Well, yeah, like I said, I think it's okay to talk about it.
See, that I think that I hold the same view as Eric, that I see most people as generally nice people, but the problem now, I think, is that when there is that one or two bad people, everyone just focuses on those one or two bad people and then just assumes, like, everyone is that bad person, like...
I mean, the problem is those bad people ruin it for everybody. That's why we focus on them.
Yeah, that's the scary part.
And I think it's, like, deteriorating, like, the country and everyone as a whole. Because what happens if, like, you know, you brought your daughter to the park and like, you know, a mom was like, oh, you know, cute kid. Probably wouldn't really think anything of it. But, like, if a dad was there and was like, yo, you got a cute daughter, you'd probably be like, first thing that would come to your head would be like, dude, what the fuck?
If it wasn't a dad, if it was just some random guy.
Yeah, I'm terrified to ever talk to somebody's child just because feel like it's everyone's going to call the police on me.
But that's the scary part, dude. Like, I'm as a, even as a parent with my kids standing next to me.
They see a man with a little girl, right?
Now that's going to be in my head. Thanks a lot.
I've just heard dads complaining about that, or people like come up to him and they're like, what are you doing here?
Well, I guess what I was going to say was, even with my kids at the park or like Billy B's or Chuck E. Cheese or anything like that, even then, like when parents see that I'm also a parent, making comments like, oh, you know, cute kid you got there, feels weird because I don't want to put that vibe out. You get what I mean?
Exactly.
Even as stupid as it sounds.
Dude, that's how it feels working as a male in the camping community. So like the person that I worked for is a very like caring female, and every time like a new kid comes, she'll give them a hug, she'll go up to the parents and be like, oh my god, like thank you for coming here. Now if I were to do that, dude, that would not,
it would look different,
it would look weird,
it would look so bad. That's like a thing that has always ran with me when I was doing, that's why I've decided to never be a camp director now, because dude, this is not, it's not the time to be a guy running a summer camp for children.
Yeah, that's sad. That's sad, though.
It's sad, dude. And, like, it doesn't help that, like, there are cases every year of that one male camp counselor at some random camp of, like, 50 people that, like, groomed a child.
And the worst part is, like, you could do everything right, because I know, obviously, I know this would never be something I would hear, but I think I get what you're saying in the sense that it would be scary because you never know. Somebody could just make up some bullshit, you know, and then all of a sudden you got to defend yourself for something you didn't do.
That's the thing. And it makes a guy's job working in that community hard because, okay, let's say that at nighttime there's a child that's, you know, not feeling well or something, there's an issue with them, and it's a girl. Dude, I would have to get another girl to come with me to go deal with this issue when I could fully deal with it by myself, but I don't even want to put myself in that situation.
Off topic, but I think that's a shitty practice of having, you have a girl counselor that's going to help, but because it's a boy, you have to have another male there. Doesn't mean that that wouldn't happen still.
It's like we see all women as like motherly for some reason, but that we can't see men as fatherly. We just, yeah.
But having worked in the same job, like, as long as you take the steps to make sure you're not in those positions, it's not that bad.
No, it's not. I mean, it's not something that I think about all the time, dude. Like, I'm never, like, worried about it. But it always crosses my mind, like, am I going too far?
Yeah, but I made sure to take the steps that I was always following those rules. Because I'm not trying to ever have anything happen, so.
And, like, another thing, too, is, like, dude, now, like, a lot of camps have social media directors and stuff like that. They're taking pictures all day long. Dude, I don't want to be in the background of a picture hugging someone's child and they're like, what the
fuck? Fuck is that guy? Yeah,
that hug looks weird, yeah.
Well, do you guys still do cash?
Yeah. Well, that's what I'm saying, dude. I mean, I'm not going to full-on front hug someone, but...
That was my secret get-out-of-jail-free card. When the kid comes running at you, keep it cash! Just so you guys know, that means camp appropriate side hug. So, you know, you kind of grab across their shoulders, but you gotta olay the kid. Because a lot of kids, you know, they don't understand it, and they just see you as somebody they really like. They want to give you a hug. So you gotta, like, swing around them like a raging bull. Grab those shoulders and be like, hey, keep it cash.
No, I think you're right, though, Fresco. This conversation should be had, because I don't think enough people take the time to do it. Then things happen, you know what I mean?
And I'm back to what we were saying. It's, for the most part, most people are good people and do not have... It would be fine if you hugged a kid normally.
Yeah, and the parent wouldn't think anything of it, yeah.
Nobody would care, but there's those few, the small percent that somebody's going to get, like... What the fuck is that? Or, you know, it's what ruins it for everybody else. It only takes one person to kick over a sandcastle. It's just, okay, well, I guess we can't do this anymore.
Yeah, we don't have that.
So hopefully it's something that does change as, like, we get just less gender focused on everything.
Yeah, I think that's a big issue.
It is.
It's those same nuts that are worried about, like I shouldn't say nuts, but somebody worried about something happening to their child. So they might go a little ham on something that wasn't meant to be taken in that context or something. But it's those same people that are like, oh, I don't want a trans woman in women's bathrooms with my daughter. Like, I don't know, dude, about you, but if that woman is trans, chances are she likes men. I don't have any statistics on, but I don't think she's into children because she's trans.
Yeah, there's still even less people who are then into children.
I mean, it sounds shitty to say, but they're already feeling like a target. I don't think they're going to make themselves an even bigger target, you know?
Yeah. No, that's for sure true.
Even if it is something that...
But this is the guy who's... This is the type of person who's ruining that for everybody. You see the picture of this dude who just showed up. He went into a woman's bathroom trying to look as manly as he could with his big cowboy hat. And then said, do I look like I belong in women's facilities? Like,
maybe you don't.
That, and they're trying to just scare the fuck out of everybody of like, this is what's going to happen.
Either way, I don't care at all.
We just need to get into like just unisex bathrooms, really. Just the whole set, I think. But
yeah, I do.
Maybe that's weird. Maybe there's something I'm missing, but I feel like if anything, the only thing I would miss is that there's always a line at a woman's bathroom, and I wouldn't want that to be added to my bathroom time as well.
I think there should just definitely just be three.
Three bathrooms?
Even if the third bathroom is just a single stall.
I mean, they have some place. They have like the family bathroom or whatever where you can bring.
SU actually has, you know, the boys and girls bathroom. And then they have unisex bathrooms where it's just anyone can go in. And the way that you know if someone's in there is like the door automatically locks and then not automatically locks, but the door like... When it closes, it has like a red light that shows up that says like it's occupied. And I've never seen lines for that.
For a second, I thought you were about to say that you walk into this bathroom, the door locks behind you when there's other people in there.
You can't get out. You have to fight.
Then there's me staying in there. What's between your legs? What's between your legs?
You interrogated.
They have these new soundproof bathrooms. That's great.
This is the cock police.
Do you have a cock?
I am the cock police. Let me see your dick.
Yeah, we just gotta straight up embrace the American way of doing things. Just put an armed guard in every bathroom.
Do you have a cock? And if you're cock, you have a cock. Does it have foreskin?
And then he's gonna get scared. I thought he was trying to kill me, so I shot him. He pulled out his dick. I thought he was pulling out a gun.
That dude had the big stick ever. There's no way there wasn't a gun.
He was big and black and he was white. I don't know.
Dude, that happens. Have you seen the videos where the cop is like feeling up a dude?
Oh, yeah, dude.
He's like, what's this?
And then he grabs his dick.
Yeah, and they're grabbing their cock.
That's my penis, sir. And I love how he goes, okay. He just tries to ignore the fact that he just grabbed his dick.
Dude, you know how big.
But how do you not know? Like, how do you not know?
If you grab a hold of a penis.
I was going to say, dude, I feel like you got to have a massive dick for someone to be like, what's this?
I don't care how big their dick was, dude. If it's a dick, you'd have to know. It's
you
a dick, dude.
You can tell it's a penis, dude. Have you felt your own penis before?
Yes.
I mean, I'm sure this dude's not packing the meat that dude is, but...
But I'm saying, what if it's so big that, like, you're not used to...
That's what I'm saying, dude. Like, the average guy's dick.
Dude, it feels like a dick.
But he's feeling exactly where a dick is. He knows where dicks are.
If only we had our resident big dick bandit, Jimmy.
He knows how they hang.
Nobody has a pocket in the front of their pants. Like,
to be fair, that guy's fucking pants are sagged hella low.
But his dick should still proportionally be there.
Yeah, you know where a dick is.
But like, it happened a second time, dude. There was another that I think it was a white guy too in the recommended. Come on, whoa!
That looks fake as fuck.
I mean, just this dude's pretty well endowed if this is the case.
I'm pretty sure this is
like a parody.
Either a parody or it's the beginning to a porno.
Yeah. Never mind. Goddamn, porno openings always getting me.
they've really gotten really creative and Americanized with these porno openings, haven't they?
But still, though, like it's not like his dick is gonna be.
You would know. I don't care. I think that guy did it, like, and was like, "Oh, what's this, dude? It's my cock." Like, what the fuck do you? What do you think it is, dude? If you trace it all the way up, it's attached to my body.
Trace it all the way up.
Well, that's what the guy was doing. That's what he was doing.
But what if it's hanging that low?
It wasn't, though.
Yeah, but what if you got a boner and you're doing the waistband thing, and now you got a fucking Glock in your waistband, but it's really your cock?
Cock Glock?
Does it is it shaped like a gun, or is it shaped like a penis?
I don't know, dude. I'm just saying, I feel like if you're a cop, there might need to be a discussion about, hey, if you're patting somebody down very thoroughly and you feel something that feels like meat, it's probably their penis.
Feels like, yeah, they should probably let you know that men have dicks generally.
Dicks, yeah.
Generally.
I will say, I patted down quite a bit of people when I was in Iraq. And I never ran into a dick. I never ran into
it.
I think you're patting in the right spots.
There were no rogue dicks.
Were you patting in the dick spot?
Well, yes, I was patting in the dick spot, but like I'm just saying, dude, like that dude's dick was probably so big that at the spot where he patted, he didn't normally touch dick and was like, what's that?
But I mean, you have to also think, you know, maybe somebody has a big dick. Like, that has to come into your mind space at some point. You might have a large... Yo, he's going in on that dick. That cop is going in on his dick. he just gave him a free handy, dude. Holy he's shit. Going,
he goes, he's like, what is this?
Yeah, he's...
Wait, at what point did he touch his dick?
It might look like he touched his belly button because his pants and shirt are low, but
right there.
Right there.
That's his penis. There's the dick.
But it doesn't look so massive.
Yeah.
Okay, dude, then he's definitely waistbanding. He had a boner. I'd be a little freaked out.
It's not illegal to have a boner.
I know it's not illegal to have a boner, but I'd be freaked out if there's a barrel-shaped thing pointing up. I would expect to be pointing out.
Maybe the cop knew exactly what it was, and he was just paralyzed in fear. He's like
please don't let this be. I think I just touched.
I mean, that's pretty much what happened with the guy in the other video with the jeans on. Dude's like trying to rip it out of his pants.
No, he's trying to move it along.
He's probably got like some rug burn on his dick after that, dude.
Like, have you guys ever had to like squeeze your phone out of your pocket and you're like pushing it to the edge ever further by like squeezing out? He's doing that with his dick, trying to pull it out of the pocket.
Maybe he wasn't circumcised, and he just didn't know that they felt like that, right?
That's the tip, though, bro.
I mean, I didn't know what circumcised meant until I was like 50.
T, you know that's where the foreskin generally is, right?
Yeah, but Bunk says you would feel for that. I'm like, are you feeling the guy's tip of his cock or something? Like that's what
I mean, he's feeling his cock. We're watching
the that video. Was the tip of that dude's dick, T.
Oh,
do you think his dick? His
I did not
attached
see the video. I did state that I did not see the video, so I'm just assuming that's why I said, why would you be?
He might have thought if he had foreskin, he might have thought it was one of those like squishy tube toys that falls through your hands.
Yeah,
he thought he had that in his pants.
Those are called water weenies.
Water weenies. Is that really what it's called?
Yeah, I had I used them in a vivid when I vividly described the guy's butthole.
Why are you describing somebody's butthole?
When I had to cut that guy's.
Oh no! Okay.
So well, because I had to cut when I had to cut that guy's butthole out, they got sodomized to death by the guitar.
Yeah, that thing.
I held the tube of it in my hand, just like that guy is holding that blue water weenie up there. Go back up a little bit. That one. I was holding a guy's like entire intact rectum, like just like that in my hand.
Was there glitter and fish in it too?
Yeah.
Gross.
It was a guitar, a Gibson? Jesus.
Yeah, he took a tuning end of a guitar up his ass. They started with a broom, and then they moved to a baseball bat, and then they moved on to the guitar, and it fucking caused him to bleed to death.
As sticking guitar ends up your ass would do.
This wasn't a consensual thing.
No, this was not consensual by the sounds of it.
You are lucky that you are not the person who has to explain that to the parents.
It started off, so it was a homosexual love triangle gone wrong.
Thrill? Were you involved in this?
So there was some jealousy involved. And
wasn't that like a mob thing? A mob thing?
No, it was not a mob thing. It was literally just three gay guys who were just getting it on, and apparently it was pretty frequent for them to use inanimate objects around the house.
Oh, really?
And then two of them got like a jealousy issue over the third guy, so one of them decided to fuck him to death with a guitar.
Oh, that's wrong. Fuck, dude.
I tell you to look up the news story, but I don't want to reveal where I work, so.
That's okay.
I'm cool on the pictures.
I doubt there would be any pictures of them.
I think the water weenie is a good enough depiction of what it looks like. Probably looks more like this one.
As man sodomized with a guitar dies, murder charges follow.
Well, speaking of weird bubbles, the Flaming Lips performed a concert in bubbles to a crowd of people in bubbles. How do you guys feel about that?
It looked like a big thing of boba tea.
Pretty, like nobody can move at all because they're all perfectly jammed in this, whatever they are at, like a club or something.
How do you get out?
That's the question, right? Yeah,
No, I mean, like, how do you leave?
I have no idea.
You don't!
Because you can't move until somebody else moves.
It's got to be like an hour-long process of like one at a time someone leaves.
What if you had to piss, dude?
That's what I'm saying. Fuck that. They'd be like, yo, move, I got to piss.
Just go in the... You got to go in the bubble. You committed to this. They're probably all wearing piss bags.
Is that called a catheter? No.
The top comment was asking, like, what happens when there's a fire?
Yo, for real, though. That's like a legitimate...
terrifying.
Yeah, that wasn't smart, I feel like.
Yo, it'd be like that scene in Prometheus where, like, the bubbles catch on fire and melt onto your face and shit. Like, you just get... all that plastic just gets melted onto your body.
So painful.
Is that the Alien prequel, Prometheus?
Yeah.
Do you like those? Because everyone I've talked to, everyone I've heard about those say they're shit, but I've not seen.
That's on Next Fucking Level? That's the weakest thing on Next Fucking Level I've ever seen.
I hate this subreddit. I actually regret bringing this up.
Everything I've seen from it is usually pretty good.
The first I ever heard of Next Fucking Level, it was constantly being like promoted on every subreddit I was on. Where in every, it was always like one of the top comments, someone was like, this is such Next Fucking Level. And I was so sick of reading that comment that I will never subscribe to this shit. But now it's one of the most popular ones ever.
I'm not sub to it, but it's...
How many things are Next Fucking Level to the point where nothing's actually Next Fucking Level?
Exactly. Anymore? That's why I hate it. Because it's just things that are kind of cool are Next Fucking Level now. Like, a bunch of people in balloons at a concert is not Next Fucking Level. This is not...
These people aren't even making use of them. Like, they could be bopping around in there. They should be bopping all over the place.
I saw one of the climbing subreddits, everyone always reposts this fucking... I think the same thing happened in the climbing Reddit. It was like Next Fucking Level, and it was a picture of that dude doing that ridiculous, like, going up the wall backwards.
Oh yeah,
seen that where he does like a cartwheel almost.
Yeah, like that's not Next Fucking Level. That's dumb.
That's just an uneducated person thinking it's Next Level.
It's physically impressive, but it's not Next Fucking Level in terms of climbing. Like no one that would really consider climbing Next Fucking Level would ever do that.
Yo, speaking of climbing, what's your opinion on like climbing skyscrapers? Is that a challenge to you?
I mean, yeah, it's fucking difficult. What do you mean?
I mean, how are you doing it? Are you saying like climbing a skyscraper, like
the guy that intentionally gets like best urban climbers? That guy right there, that dude is really famous. He's known. He's been arrested multiple times for climbing buildings and shit. And it's like it's just as difficult as rock climbing. I mean, it's technical. Some people on lower buildings, they call it bouldering. It's fucking dumb.
Yo, I remember this.
This doesn't look like the hardest thing though. If you're a top level climber,
like those kids are pretty dumb. Like the other guy is legitimately a professional climber.
There is a difference between dumb and difficult. Where like parts of this, it does look like he's climbing a ladder. Like this is a ladder, but it's just like, yeah, you're gonna die.
It's a ladder of death, bro. Like you can't.
Yeah, but
it's
he's just doing that with ladder. No equipment, dude. That's fucking
free. This is free soloing. That's technically a free solo.
Yes.
What do you mean by technically? You mean literally?
Yeah, literally. Well, it was. I thought free solo was like you got to be on a mountain, but
no, it's just free soloing is climbing something with no protection, no gear. You just got a chalk bag and shoes.
God dang, in our chat.
My thing is, dude, is if I was the owner of that building, I'd be super pissed. So because yeah, if someone dies doing that shit, like that's
sure,
on you.
Sure.
Yeah, and that's it. Why the.
Well, probably got to sign your. I think you can legally sign your life away to do stunts like that.
No, dude, if someone dies on your property, like it's on you.
They use your insurance.
Dude, if they what?
He's like all the guy that I mentioned that I pointed out to Bunk was arrested on several occasions.
So do like the Walindas have a fucking fee or something? Like, hey, you know, one of us falls off these ropes, you're paying for it.
They just do it illegally, and like There's no discussion. They just do it.
Yeah, they don't ask you to climb up their building because you're gonna say no. Like that's...
the only times on record that I'm completely familiar with where there was a case where someone was illegally climbing a building was Alex Honnold was doing this thing for his he's doing like a promo for climbing in like some impoverished region of Africa, and for a promo stunt to like get the city hype, he climbed the 5-star hotel that he was staying in.
They allowed it,
but I'm sure there was a safety involved too.
Yes, they did. They did allow.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure there's definitely been other stunts
it does
like
happen,
that.
For sure,
not like, a lot.
Didn't Tom Cruise climb a building?
It's the same argument why people don't like skateboarding.
That's why he did it in Africa. Yeah, that's why he did it in Africa, because like that would never happen in the United States.
Yeah, skateboarding is a great comparison to that, where like, yeah, people skateboard on shit all the time, but you're not supposed to.
Yeah, like I was watching something the other day about that, and it was like this old man yelling at like kids to like leave hit the building from skating on it, and everyone like the comment section was just like, that dude's a dick, blah blah blah. And then there's like some dude that was a lawyer, and he actually, no, that dude's not, he's like looking out for himself, like these kids are dicks. And then everyone's response to that was, oh, well, skaters never sue, like skateboarders aren't like that. It's like, dude, I'm not gonna take my chance on that.
It's the risk, yeah.
That you don't know who those suburban white moms would do.
Yeah, it's not them, it's their moms. It's not, I'm not worried about the 13-year-old suing me.
Like, yeah.
The Karen, I got, oh, okay. I think I once heard a story where a burglar hurt himself on the property and he sued them successfully because he still got hurt.
Yes, you can do that, dude. If you're a burglar and there's some states where, like, let's say you're a burglar, you're in my house, and then I somehow lock you into my house or like lock you into my basement because you're in my basement. There's been cases where people have countersued and said that it was false imprisonment, even though they're breaking into someone else's house.
It's the American way. You can always be sued.
You can always get out of anything if you have a good lawyer.
No matter what. You can always get out of anything and you can always be sued. May the richest man win.
Back to my climbing thing, though, but there was this biopic I once saw where this dude, this is more like tight roping, but I forgot the name of this movie, but it's based on a true story. Where this
Man on a Wire?
That's literally like that's the most famous one.
Were you with me that time in the previews when we saw that, or I saw that?
I don't know.
Like some guy on a tight rope.
This is really old.
This is a long time ago this came out. He walked between the Twin Towers, right?
No, there was like someone who did... Not the actual recording of it. There was like a...
There was a movie about him.
Right.
But I feel like that was also a long time ago that came out.
No, I'm just saying, like, I think so. Doing recklessly dangerous stuff like that. I mean, how did Evel... When Evel Knievel went down a few times, he did.
Dude, Evel Knievel got fucked up, and he kept doing it, too. Evel Knievel is a pretty rad dude. As far as an idiot is concerned, like he was not able to do the things that he thought he could, and he just kept trying and like fucking himself up.
Well, the whole point is he's got to see what he could possibly do.
Yeah, he jumped over a fountain and ended up in a coma.
Yeah, this is like his first big attempt. Is in Las Vegas, he convinced. This is before he was any good. He convinced Las Vegas, like some casino, a big casino there, to let him jump in front of it as this big attraction. And I don't even know if they paid him. He immediately fails. Pretty sure he shatters his ribs and just fucks himself up. And he's just like on like a regular street bike or something. But the bike was almost incapable of making this jump.
Oh, well, man, I guess if you're making hundreds of thousands of millions, I have no idea.
He's not making hundreds of millions of dollars.
He was making nothing here. He was like, he was nobody doing this. He was just some guy
jumping cars for fun.
But he convinced them that he was somebody. And they're like, okay, he says he can do it. And they line up all these people. Everyone's
to watch
outside.
Watch a man die.
Yeah, we're going to see. And then he just destroyed.
He was at least lucky enough to do it in his day before the internet. Because now the internet, like, who gives a shit? You jumped over a car. You crashed on a motorcycle. I've seen 1,000 of those videos for breakfast. I could imagine seeing that for breakfast.
Right. But even if right now somebody tried to do the shit that Evel Knievel's doing, I think it would be pretty big news.
Yeah, we've seen some impacts. We've seen some serious impacts there. I've
seen at least for the time.
I don't know, dude. I think with YouTube out, man, people just do that shit.
Yeah, but they're not doing it like Evel. They're bitches.
I mean, they probably also don't have the clout that he.
People do some pretty dumb shit.
Man, this brought back flashbacks. A motorcycle crash was like one of the first videos of a death I've ever seen. My brother was watching.
I don't want to watch people die, dude.
No, I saw this accidentally as a kid. Like, my brother was watching a video.
Is this what sparked your interest in death comps?
Possibly. May have opened up a dark deep. Yeah, he showed me this video where this news reporter lady was just sitting on by a back of a truck. This motorcycle comes exploding out, and she died on screen. There's a puff of smoke, but they later confirmed she died. And then he played another video where this motorcycle crashed into a tightrope, like a net to catch tightrope people, and he fell and he broke his neck live on video.
That's hot.
How did he crash into the net? Like, what? Under what circumstances was this?
He was at like some. I don't. He, it's a
was
long
he like trying
time.
To jump?
Yeah, he was. He was trying to do a jump or something. It was in like a circus or something. He rode a motorcycle. It went up in the air.
Oh, okay. I thought it was just a dude driving a motorcycle.
Yeah, his dad's. My brother loves bikes. That's how. That's where it starts.
No, but I thought it was just like a random motorist just driving, and then he just hits a net.
Just gets clotheslined by a fucking circus net out of nowhere.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I'm just like, what are the circumstances here? Oh, I mean, you know, you're trying to start. You might die, dude. That's.
Yeah, I mean, it's saying something that I have this greatest hits of Evel Knievel playing, and it's all crashes. I haven't seen him achieve any of the jumps
yet. Yeah, he hasn't made
it. This dude is world famous for this, and he's only failed so far. Oh!
He's the first Johnny Knoxville.
Johnny Knoxville does not do shit this crazy.
Johnny Knoxville, like, ripped his dick open, didn't he?
he tried to do a backflip.
Oh, God, dude.
And it tore his urethra, dude.
Yeah, he did.
Oh, my fucking God, that would be so painful.
Yeah, he literally broke his dick.
And Butterball, I think, broke his jaw. Or Butterbean.
Butterball.
I mean, Johnny Knoxville is one of the raddest dudes on the planet. Is that he?
For sure.
He does not give a fuck about his own safety, and we have him to thank for endless entertainment. An entire generation.
I think other people did crazier shit, though.
True, true. But I think he was a catalyst of that whole Jackass community.
I think my deck's broke.
One of my favorite scenes from Jackass is when they're testing this police.
The rubber ball shooter?
Rubber bullet thing,
oh my
yeah.
God, dude.
When they did the fucking Claymore, dude?
Yeah, and it just... Pow!
It blows up and it just shoots them with... Just pummels them with pellets. Of...
When it happens, I love how they just instantly collapse. It just takes them down immediately.
I love it when they first show them what it's going to do.
When they see what it looks like.
And everyone's like, fuck that.
And they're like, nah, nah, nah.
And they're packing up, they're ready to leave. And he's like, what? No, come on.
Come on, get shot by that thing.
We came all this way. We're doing it.
We came all the way here.
Just close your eyes.
I think that's definitely one of the gnarliest things they've done. Yeah, go ahead. Let's see. I think it's Bam who just instantly drops.
Because he was the most adamant about not doing it.
Look at him. Johnny took it like a man. I'll give him that. But look at, like, Bam hasn't moved, dude. It's him and then he just goes down.
He literally goes down and then doesn't move. He accepts death so fast. He's like, I'm done.
Get this man some milk.
Really, though, dude, that's one of the most fucked up things I've ever seen. The fact that they would use that on humans.
I think this is the part I love, right?
Yeah, man, fuck that.
They immediately leave right when they see it.
Dude, like the welts they show that they got from that.
Yeah, they're gnarly, dude. Everywhere. You know how fucking long it's going to take? For you to feel good again,
dude.
Yeah.
Hey, is this okay? Then we're good.
What the fuck is Musk talking about there? I hate him so much.
He really is just an evil villain at this point who just loves memes.
Yeah, Tesla's up to now like $450 less.
But they don't actually do anything, though. Like,
we're talking about that Elon Musk recently announced that the Model S Tesla will now cost $69,000 and $69,420 instead of, yeah. So he dropped it $5,500 for a meme.
Where's my goddamn Roadster? Like, what the fuck?
But
like,
he dropped the price, did he not, though?
He did drop the price, so it was a good thing.
Where's my roadster, Elon? That's what I want to fucking know.
You're gonna buy the roadster,
Did
T?
Did you buy a roadster or what? Like, what? No. What do you mean?
If I was gonna, if I can get one exotic car in my entire life, somehow, some way,
it would be something that costs $300,000.
I heard it was less than that. No, I wouldn't do that.
It probably is. Yeah, but
I was gonna spend that much money on a car. I'm not buying a Tesla.
No.
Wait, how much are we talking?
I have no idea how much it was cost. I was just.
Oh, are you talking about the price getting lowered to $69,420?
Oh, we were. Now we're just talking about
How Terrell plans on buying the new Roadster whenever it comes out.
Look at the price. I want
to
see the price.
I'm trying to. I have no idea. I don't think.
I definitely buy a Model S. Model S's are dope.
There's many little things that say price.
$200.
If I'm spending $200,000 on a car, it's not going to be a Tesla.
You have to put a $50,000 reservation on it? Fuck that.
Yeah, for a $200,000 car that they're like custom making for you?
Oh, so it's actually $250,000 because it's $200,000 after.
Well, no, that's for the Founders series.
Yeah, but also car prices are always more expensive than they say they are. So every car that comes out and it's like it'll be out for whatever, $25.99, it's really going to be $32 something because.
Yeah, but that's the one that comes without the wheels.
Yeah, exactly.
$200K would get you an okay-ish Ferrari.
I get a McLaren.
T, it'd definitely get you more than a 2001 Corvette.
How much is T's soul really worth?
We already know. He's told us the price is a 2001 Corvette.
Or a thing of fruit roll-ups.
No, that was his nuts.
2001. What is about the 2001 Corvette that appeals?
Man, look how ugly that thing is.
That's how. The price of a 2001 Corvette is what he's willing to sell his soul for.
Oh, okay. So it's, every year it goes down a little bit? Or is
no,
that...
it was whenever this was said.
It just so happened that was
$50,000
he was willing to sell it for.
No, it was, did you say 15?
It was like 27, it was like, I thought it was 21.
No.
I'm pretty sure he said 15,000, and that's why the... A 2001 Corvette is worth like $15,000.
I think it's worth more than that. It's a Corvette.
No, it's literally on the screen right now.
If we're talking about 2001.
The new Corvette, they actually did right though. New Corvette's pretty dope.
There's too much grip on those tires to like.
Lips that grip. It's a great subreddit.
Yeah. Okay. Well, I think that's enough for the podcast. They're calling it right there. Thanks for coming, guys.
Make sure you look up porn subreddits.
Yeah, if you have any porn subreddits to shout out, now's the time.
Let us know.
Reviews on iTunes, much appreciated and loved.